Hello and Namaste to dear blood donors and volunteers around the world. The International Youth Committee, IYC of International Federation of Blood Donor Organization, IFBDO, FIODS, has the pleasure of inviting you to the first virtual International Youth Forum, which was started from 21st, and this is the final day of the International Youth Forum, which is being carried out in Microsoft Team platform. The title of this forum is Health and Healthy Blood Donations Are Always Priorities. It's me, your host, Aryan Upreti from Nepal, who is acting as Financial Secretary to IYC and President of Club 25 Nepal. I would like to welcome you all again for the final day of International Youth Forum. So starting with today's program, we are going to start with the ice-breaking game like we did yesterday. So starting with the ice-breaking game, I would like to request Francesca, who is Continental Delegates for European Region for IYC, to carry out the game. Francesca.
Thank you. Thank you, Ariane. And thank you, everybody, for being here for the third day. And thank you, all of you, for joining us. So before starting all the session, as usual, we would like to warm you up. And today, actually, we would like to test your creativity. So I don't know, are you with creativity, if you are more scientific, or if you like letters, painting, or something like that. But today, we are going to invent a story. Because actually, you know, Narmin, in her spread time, she is a writer. So now, we are going to help Narmin to create a story. So what is the main point, the main rules? I'm going to give you some words. And I'm going to start with one person. Then that person has to pick a word and start telling the story. So starting with a sentence. You don't have any rules. So you can use your imagination however you want. So the point actually is to use all the letter, all the words. So now I'm going to show you all the words by a slide, and I'm starting with calling one person. Then after this, when the person was able to create that sentence with one of the words that he would like or she would like to pick, he has to give the ball to someone else. So if you see the names on your teams, you can call by names. If you don't see the names, because I don't know, sometimes with teams it's a bit hard, you can try with nationalities. So you call a country, and then the people from that country can choose who will take the ball, will continue the game. Okay? Do you have questions? Okay, let's start then. Okay. Tell me when you see.
You can see it.
Okay, perfect. So, since we are going to help Narmin, you start. Pick the word you want, and then you give the ball to someone else.
Hey, once upon a time, there was a doctor. There was only one doctor in a village. And now I would like Elena to continue.
Hello.
The red words cannot be used again.
One morning, the doctor wake up and make himself a cup of tea.
Okay.
Kunal.
Okay. Hello.
Sorry? I couldn't hear, sorry.
In the meantime, I request the other participant to turn off their mic.
Okay. Kunal, can you say it again?
I have to make a sentence with a cup of tea.
No, we already used a cup of tea. So this doctor is in the village. After waking up, he's making a cup of tea. And after then, you have to continue the story by using another word.
Any what?
The word, can you see the screen?
No.
Okay. I can tell you some. You can use one of them. You can use princess, you can use dragon, you can use forest, blood, internet connection, a chair.
So he's a doctor.
Doctor, no, because you already used it. You can use pizza, bike, yellow, needle, mask, joyfulness or coffee bean.
So doc, now I am ready to going to donate blood now. After drinking a cup of tea, I'm ready to go to donate blood.
Okay.
The doctor,
after having a cup of tea, is going to donate blood.
Yeah.
Oh, perfect. Let's give the ball to another person or another country, if you can see the names of the participants.
Okay, I'm not getting the participant's name. I'm on mobile today, so.
Oh, okay, don't worry. So let's pick a country. Like, Denmark, Nepal,
Siri?
Romania.
Siri?
Norway. Norway, okay.
Okay, I can continue the story for a while. So in order for the doctor to come to the blood center to donate, he took a bike through the forest.
Okay, a bike.
Okay.
Perfect. Another one?
A bike through the forest.
Okay. Another person?
You have to choose a person now. Like pick a person. Pass the ball.
Okay. I pick up Nepal.
Okay. So someone from Nepal? Apart from me?
I would choose joyfulness. Once upon a time, there was a girl. Her heart seemed
Let's continue the story.
Yes, continue the story.
So the doctor that took a bike after a cup of tea to donate blood.
And he seemed overflowing with joyfulness when he donated the blood.
Okay. And keep send the ball to someone else.
I'll give it to Selena Los Gypician. If I could spell it.
No, it's fine. but even with all his joyfulness, he was a little scared of the needle. Mm-hmm. And I will give it to Ayan.
Okay. So after donating blood in the blood bank, he wore a mask because of the pandemic and returned back to his home.
Okay, Ariane, choose someone else.
Okay, so I would be choosing. Where is Rodrigo? I can't see him. Rodrigo?
Rodrigo, it's your turn.
Can you hear me?
Yes.
Okay, so when returning home, when he was crossing the forest, he came across a dragon.
Okay,
so now I'm going to choose Taran.
All right, so the dragon was totally lost and looking for internet connection. And then he asked the doctor. All right, I'm giving it to Italy. Someone from Italy.
Someone from Italy?
Can you hear me?
Yes.
Okay, suddenly a princess appears.
Give the ball to someone else. Who do you want to continue the story?
To Tatiana.
Okay.
The princess was eating a pizza. So I'm gonna give the ball to who didn't talk yet. Simon?
Yeah, and she was drinking a yellow cocktail.
A yellow cocktail. Guys, the story is already done. We have two more words. Let's see how it's going to end. Simon, who do you want to give the ball to?
Dr. Karin.
Okay. Okay, I will finish it because the time has passed. The doctor liked the princess so much with her yellow cup that he invited her home to sit in the chair and have a cup of coffee made from fresh coffee beans.
Okay. Very nice.
What happened to the dragon?
He's still looking for internet connection.
In the forest. I feel like you're going to someplace you're not going to find that it's there.
Narmin, you have to let the dragon find a way, even without internet connection.
Well, if you think that currently there are no dragons in the world, then that dragon also disappeared. He was just looking for a internet connection, but unfortunately he couldn't find.
Okay. So guys, thank you so much for playing. I hope you enjoyed, and let's see if Narmin will make a real story out of this beginning. Thank you again, and Ariane.
Thank you, Francesca, for a wonderful game. So now I would like to move towards the second session. The session would be a very wonderful session as it's a presentation, and it is one of the defined session as per our theme. That is health and healthy donations are always priorities. So for a topic, health of blood donors and healthy donations, I would like to request Dr. Karan, who is a FIODS chairman of medical committee, and she has got more than 30 years of experience. I know like most of us are haven't reached that age as well, and we are below that age. So she has been working ever since when we weren't born. So she has got a deep interest and a great experience in the field of blood management and blood donations. So I would like to request Dr. Karen for her presentation and give us her insightfulness. Thank you. Dr. Karen.
You have my presentation and we'll show it, right?
Yes.
Just one minute.
Yes, no hurry. So I'm very pleased to be here with all of you young people. it will, as requested from you guys, be a story about the protection of donor health. You should go in presentation mode.
Francesca? Yes.
You should probably say yes, good. Yes, and the next, please. Good. You who are the donors, you give a part of yourself to help others. So, of course, it is very important to prioritize the health of all of you, both from the blood centers, but you should also yourself take care of your health. The next. So from Denmark, there have been some research on what the donors, what is important for you. So you can think if you agree with what this research has come up with, namely the welcoming of the donor, respect towards the donor, acknowledgement of the donor, and not the least to say thank you. Do you all agree with that, something that is important for you?
Yes.
Good. Also important has been found to be the accessibility to the blood center, such as opening hours, proximity, and places to park. Next. So for donor health care, next. The donor interview and the questionnaire is a first line of defense created for the patients, but it also protects the donor. And to ensure that you are fit to donate, to ensure that you are healthy and you didn't have risk behavior, you didn't travel to countries that carry diseases not frequent at your home country, that what medication you take, and that you have a sufficient blood volume. Next. There is a project going on in Europe on the protection and selection of donors, where most countries participate. They aim to identify what is necessary to know about donation and the donors, to take care of the donors. So when you donate whole blood, in your blood there is plasma. This is a picture I learned from Fleming. You have a little more than half is plasma, plasma-containing proteins, coagulation factors, hormones and vitamins, and you have the cells, which is roughly 45%, which is mainly red blood cells, but also platelets and white blood cells. So, back again, please. So, to regenerate the lost red blood cells, you need mainly iron, which I will talk at length about later, but you also need vitamin B12, which is only found in animal food, and you need folic acid, which is found in leafy vegetables, in legumes, and in liver. Okay, next. So once you have donated, you need to regenerate. Next. So you are mainly donating red blood cells. In the red blood cells, you have hemoglobin. And if you want to want more. Yes. So before donation, you will have one concentration of hemoglobin, and it will naturally fall after you donate some of your red cells, and it will take roughly 1 month before you have the same concentration as you had before you donated. This is quite normal. You need to regenerate what you are donating. The next. And once more. In order to generate red blood cells, you need iron. And this is a picture of iron. You can see before you donate, you have one iron store. And in the same time as you regenerate your red blood cells, you use iron. And you actually use more iron that you can regenerate over 3 months if you're not taking any iron tablets. So your iron stores will drop every time you donate if you donate every 3 months. Yes. Also your fitness. I'm not sure how many of you who are very active in fitness. I know in Norway very many are very fit. So after you donate, your fitness is always like it depends that on that you have enough red cells, enough hemoglobin. So it's not a surprise that your fitness will drop after donation, but it will come back to the pre-donation level after 2 or 3 weeks. And it tends to come back faster if you are super fit, and it can take up to 4 weeks if you are less fit. So the next, and the same for endurance, how long it takes you to run, for example, 3 kilometers. After donation, not surprisingly, it will take somewhat longer, but also after 2 to 3 weeks, it will come back to normal. The next. So when donating, there are a small risk of some adverse events. Next. For instance, there's a risk of fainting, which is caused by like diminished flow of blood to the brain. A kind of interesting thing is that when you faint after donation, it's because you are scared. It's psychology. And for the women, when they faint, it's mainly because of too low blood volume. The next. What you can do to prevent to faint is to rest after donation. Before donation, you should have a good night's sleep and regular meals. Liquid is very important. It's very important to be well hydrated. And also immediately before donation to drink at least 0.5 liter. This 0.5 liter will increase your blood pressure a little bit, and that way it will reduce your risk of fainting. In the days up to the donation, it can be good to eat more salt. Usually salt is not very healthy, but in 2 to 3 days up to the donation, it helps to eat salt. And something that is quite effective is applied muscle tension during donation. Have any of you heard of that? Applied muscle tension? No? No?
Yeah.
It's I couldn't find any movies of it, but it's during the donation, if you rhythmically contract your muscles, you can do it without actually moving anything. Just tense your muscle and relax and tense and relax. You can also, I know it, an Italian study where they asked the donors to lift the legs a little bit and crossing them from over it, like zigzag over each other. That is very helpful to increase your blood pressure a little bit, and you will feel much better after the donation and with a much lower risk of fainting. Okay, at the next. In order to prevent needle injury, a good compression of the puncture wound after donation is important, and you can help doing that if you keep the pressure on the puncture wound for 2 to 3 minutes. Also, after donation, you should avoid carry heavy things or doing strenuous exercise on the day of donation. The next. Okay, so what you lose a lot of after a whole blood donation, and therefore is very important, is iron. Iron is needed in all organisms, also coronaviruses. Iron is a prerequisite for life on Earth. And in man, iron is, for instance, needed to create hemoglobin, myoglobin. Myoglobin is an important protein in muscle. It is for DNA and ATP generation, energy generation, and also for brain enzymes. Next. But too much iron is toxic. So, the consequences of iron deficiency is, next. You, the girls, if you have iron deficiency, you have no iron stores for pregnancy, which is very important. It may lead to preterm birth and a small fetal baby. Next. It can lead to anemia and also muscle fatigue and reduced endurance and impaired cognitive functions and clinical symptoms like pica, where you eat very strange things like earth or chalk or the like. Next. And also restless leg syndrome. Next. And nail and mouth problems. So next slide. So impaired cognitive function means that you will not be as good to solve problems and remember stuff. And also iron is needed for the development of the brain, which goes from before birth until the beginning and mid 20s. So iron is quite important. Next. So how do we take up and store iron? In a healthy diet, you will eat 1 to 2 milligrams of iron per day. This picture is the segment of the duodenum, which is immediately south of your stomach, where your food comes through the stomach and into this piece just after the stomach, where you have a very acidic milieu. If you drink a juice or much worse, soda water, soft drinks are often very acidic. But also here you have acid in the stomach, and here you have a very acidic milieu, which is necessary to absorb iron. So iron is absorbed here and not so much further down where it is less acidic. The next. So from here, iron is absorbed into the plasma, where it is bound to a protein called transferrin. Next. And most of this iron is used for building red cells. And in blood donors, it is as much as 75% that is used for building red cells. The next. Luckily, there's to a large degree recycling. The red cells will go to some of the white cells called macrophages, where a lot of it is recycled. Next. So if you eat more iron than you use, it will be stored in the liver. Next. The next. Before. Yes, in the liver, the iron is stored in a huge protein called ferritin. Ferritin is built like a ball, and it contains up to 4,000 iron atoms in the center of this ferritin. In the ferritin, I don't know if you can see it, but there are channels where the iron can come in and out. So the next. So how do we get enough iron to donate? Meat is a very good iron source, both meat, fish and shellfish. The iron that you find in meat is easily absorbable, heme iron. And also in meat, you have a meat factor that increases iron uptake in general. Next. White bread has a phytate, which is a very strong inhibitor of iron uptake, so this is not good. But if you have whole grain that have been in a moist milieu for hours, the iron and other minerals will be accessible. Yes, and next. In vegetables, there are some ions, but also inhibitors. The inhibitors are phytate and in some vegetables also oxalic acid. Spinach is known to contain quite a large amount of iron, but actually hardly any of it is taken up because of the oxalic acid and the phytate. So iron is very healthy, spinach is very healthy, but it does nothing for your iron stores. The next. Fruit is also very healthy. It contains a little iron, but vitamin C, which helps iron uptake. But it also often contains polyphenols, which are inhibitors. So if there is any effect towards iron, is actually not really known. The next. Dairy products have little effect on iron uptake. Normal milk may inhibit a little bit, where the yogurt and such, which are more acidic, can perhaps help uptake. Next. Tea and coffee greatly inhibits iron uptake due to polyphenols. So it is best to, for perhaps not all your meals, but two of your meals, you should avoid to have coffee or tea at least 1 hour before and after the meal. Next. Okay, when you are a blood donor, it is difficult or almost impossible to even on a healthy diet, get enough iron. I'm not sure that actually this slide should have been here, but anyway, here it is. So it can try to take the next one. Yes. So you can consider to take iron tablets. You should never take more than one once a day. And it's best also to take a break after some weeks. Okay, then next. So in conclusion, safeguarding of you, the donors, is of utmost importance, and the protection of you must never become inferior to possible monetary gains. And next. And thank you. I don't know if we have time for questions, but if we do, you're welcome. You look like you're talking, Ayan, but I cannot hear you.
Yes, we have time for questions. So any participants who have questions, please raise your hand, or you can just turn on your mic and you can ask your question.
I have raised.
Yes, Abdul.
How are you all? I miss you all, Dr. Karin. It's good to see you.
You too.
And Aryan, lovely IYC team.
I could see there was a lot of comments on coffee. And I also love coffee. You don't have to do it right absolutely every day, but I try to avoid coffee after lunch and dinner and drink coffee with my breakfast.
I wanted to ask you, Dr. Karin, is do you think that raising the legs or the sitting position when someone is donating really does have an effect on reducing the risk of any vasovagal or any other
it is very effective as a kind of cure if you start to feel so you have two things. You can yourself cross your legs like I can perhaps show it, can you see it like this but you can also so tense your muscles statically, rhythmically. It has been proven to have an effect, so it does have an effect. Another thing is that if you have fainted, the staff will lift your legs into the air, and that will help return blood to your brain, and it is very efficient as well.
I just wanted to know if you think that as a preventive action, not as a...
As a preventive action, tense applied muscle tension is one of the things that has been proven to be most helpful.
Thank you.
From also be well hydrated.
I also got a question, if that's all right. I heard you said something about soft drink and iron uptake. Could you repeat that, please?
It was an attempt to explain that if you have an acidic milieu, you can pH values, that is very low. Do you know of that?
Yeah.
You have hydrochloric acid in the stomach that goes to the first part of your gut, and that is necessary, not only helpful, but necessary for the iron to be absorbed.
Okay, and drinking a soft drink would ruin that, or?
No, it was just a stupid attempt to explain.
Oh, explain, okay.
It is. Yeah.
Okay, then I get it. Thank you,
Dr. Karin.
There's a question in the chat from Mila.
Yes, there is a question from the chat from Mila from Indonesia. Dr. Karin, can you see it or?
Can I see it? There's a lot of questions.
The recent one. A few of our platelets donors won't donate again because they feel discomfort while donating from criteria reaction.
Yeah. Yes, that actually feels very unpleasant. I haven't tried it myself, but you can see it feels unpleasant. The risk of having the citrate reaction depends on your blood volume, actually. How big are you? How much blood do you contain? So the smaller you are, the higher is the risk of having such a reaction. You can quite easily, most of the time, you can quite easily help stopping the reaction if you, for instance, if you drink milk. Milk contains calcium, and you can also, if you have calcium tablets that are easily absorbed, that will help. I remember a donor who had very severe unpleasant reactions, and it turned out that she was low in vitamin D and did not drink milk ever. So after a course where she actually drank milk most of the days and also took vitamin D supplementation, she tried platelet-phoresis again, and it was much, much better. So whenever you have platelet-phoresis donations, it is important for the blood center to have either calcium or milk milk to give to the donors if they have reactions.
Okay. Any questions from our participants? Well, I don't see any questions. So I would like to thank Dr. Corinne for her time, despite of her busy schedules and during the vacation time. So it's really a pleasure to have you in our International Youth Forum and get insightful information regarding protection for blood donors. Really, thank you a lot, Dr. Karin.
You're very welcome. I'll stay here and listen to Fleming as well.
So,
thank you so much, Dr. Karin.
Thank you so much, Karin.
So now moving to us further to our program. Now we have a presentation or a talk from Dr. Fleming regarding health, nutrition, and behavior of blood donors. Dr. Fleming is from Danish Blood Donor Association, and he has got quite a bit of experience in regards of blood donors and their behavior activities. So Dr. Fleming will be talking about what are the behavioral changes or what are the stuffs we need in health nutrition. He would be talking and he would be having his time with us. So let's welcome Dr. Fleming.
Thank you very much. I'm really happy to have been invited here to talk to you. I'll have a presentation. I have the presentation here myself. I think I'll try to manage it from my own PC. Let's see if it works. Is this visible for you?
Yes,
it's perfect. Yeah,
okay.
You can see. Thank you.
Fine, very fine. What I'm going to talk about is healthy nutrition and behavior of blood donors. It's building, of course, in part on Karin's presentation right now. But what I also will stress here is, first of all, I'll have a word or two about the organizational setup in Denmark. Then a word or two of why the healthy nutrition and the donor behavior are important questions. And finally, what can we do to educate the donors? First, the Danish Blood Donor Organization. It's a private organization. It was founded back in 1932. Our mission statement is to promote the blood donor cause in general, take care of blood donors' interests, and first of all, ensure that there is enough voluntary and unpaid donors. In order to our hospitals always are being able to give blood to those that need it for treatment. We are divided into local cores around the country. We have 50 independent organizations throughout the country, and it's not a big country, so it's quite a lot of local cores. We have 5 regional boards. Then we have a national committee consisting of 42 members and a national board with 11 members. And finally, we have a national office with 8 staff. Not all of them are full-time employed, but it is around 4.5 man years. In the country, all in all, we have around 450 volunteers helping to recruit new donors. The funding of the organization, we are lucky enough that our local cause receives money from the blood bank for every donation. It's around 7 to 8 euro per blood or plasma donation. And furthermore, we have on the national level roughly 425,000 euros from other sources. We have 180,000 blood donors. It has been dropping for the last at least 10 years in the same speed as the need for whole blood is dropping. But on the other hand, the need for plasma is increasing a lot. We recruit 34,000 new donors each year. Not all of them manage to get the needle in the arm for the first time, but many of them do. All in all, we have 206,000 donations for whole blood and 76,000 for plasma, and a few for platelets and others. So, why is donor health important? It's important because the donors, they are volunteers and they should not be harmed. It's the decent thing to treat the donors in a good way. It's of course also important if the donors are paid, but especially when they are volunteers and unpaid, you have to treat them very well. And also, it's perhaps a little lazy on our part, because a healthy donor may have a longer donor career, and it's a lot more easy to recruit an existing donor to the next donation than it is to get a whole new donor. And then, why is the healthy nutrition important? As we heard from Karin, just before and after a donation, it's especially important in order to prevent adverse reactions. It's fainting or just feeling uncomfortable. And the reason for that is that the body needs salt, liquid, and sugar. And also, as we heard from Karin, to regenerate the red blood cells, you need iron. So, do the donors know about this? In general, they don't. And who is going to tell them then? You are. As volunteers in the organization, someone has to tell them, and it's your job when you get home. And just a little word about this presentation in general. It will be much more, let's say, hands-on, building on all the knowledge that you have received from Karin just now, and perhaps also for the first 2 days. So I'll give you some examples of how we educate our donors in Denmark. We have a magazine. It comes twice a year. It's sent to all the donors and also published on our website. I've included a link to the website. If you get the presentation afterwards, you are free to go and have a look at our magazine. I can show you the front page of the latest volume of this magazine. It's number 126, so it has been issued for quite some time. In this magazine, we have four pages that is dedicated to new donors. And in that, we try to educate them about how to stay healthy and how to eat well and how to behave in general. And just a word about this, you should not be afraid of repeating yourself when you are talking to the donors. Remember, you perhaps know that you have said this several times before when you trying to get a message across to the donors, but you will never have all the donors listening in one time. So there will always be someone who hasn't heard this before. And also you hopefully get new donors all the time. So also the new donors need to hear this. So this is a piece of advice. Don't be afraid of repeating yourself. Another example, it's pamphlets. They are available in the blood banks, and we also publish them on our website. We have an example. It's called Off to a Good Start, and it's a good start as a new donor. I can show you the front page of that. Looks a little like one of the drawings Karin showed us recently. Going back just a word about this, you can see the link to the pamphlet, and you are more than welcome to take the pamphlet. It's in Danish, of course, but Google Translate can do miracles, and you are welcome to take all that you can use from this pamphlet and use it in your own country. Please feel free to do so. Another pamphlet coming up, also distributed to all the blood banks and published on the website. It's specifically about blood donors and iron, and it draws a lot of those examples that Karin just mentioned. Also, there is a link there. Again, feel free to use whatever you can. I can tell you a little about the key messages here. There's some words about why iron is important and what you can do to have a better iron store. As also Karin mentioned, meat, fish and shellfish are good things. Bread is not that good. It's really only when it's whole grain and it is long-term raised. There's good things in raisins, in nuts, in beans and lentils, and fruit and vegetables for vitamin C, but with exceptions also, as Karin mentioned. Also a word of caution about coffee, tea and cocoa, and finally some words about red wine. It contains iron and polyphenols, which would be a good thing, but taken together with a meal, it is not so good for the body to uptake the the iron from the food itself. So the wine, the red wine, may be good, maybe not that good. Perhaps you should take a glass of red wine after your meal or before your meal, but not with your meal. Another example, it's a poster. It's distributed to the blood banks, and I have taken an old example. You can see it here. It draws on the pamphlet, so it's the same messages. And you can see it's an old poster because of the red wine. Here it is recommended with the red wine, and that is why we do not distribute this poster anymore. It's obsolete because of new knowledge that, as I mentioned, the red wine will inhibit the uptake of iron from the meal. So that's why we're not that keen on this poster anymore. But as an example of what you can do to educate the donors, it will do. Also, another example of education of the donors, posts on social media, mainly Facebook in our example. We have a lot of followers. We have more than one Facebook page. One is for the whole country, and then we have some more regional Facebook sites also. There's an example here. Remember to drink enough, when especially when it's warm, and also in the post there was this word of precaution about coffee and tea that is not very helpful. So water is the preferred liquid. And my final example, it's a video distributed via social media also. It's Facebook and YouTube. There's a link here so you can see it. It's from one of our regional pages where the CEO of the blood bank, the chief of it all, is talking to the donors. I have a screenshot here. Oh, he's eating some junk food. What's now that? Well, he has a word or two about it. I'll see if we can perhaps look at the video from the start. It's in Danish, of course, but it's only 1 minute. Can you see this? Is it going through to you?
No, I don't think so.
It's not. Never mind, you have the link so you can try it for yourself. I can tell you what he is telling us. Mainly it's a word about, well, maybe you as a donor is surprised when you come to the blood bank of what you are being offered. It's chips and it's Coca-Cola and it's other drinks. And why is that? That is because you need salt, liquid and sugar. It's a bad idea to go to the blood bank on an empty stomach. So eat and drink in the hours before, and let's together make sure that you have a good and nice experience in the blood bank. So, well, that is what I have. I can conclude with some takeaways for you. Healthy nutrition, it's important for donor health. You have heard why, especially from Kine. The donors do not know much about that, so it's your job to tell them and use all your available communication channels. And finally, don't be afraid of repeating yourself. They need to know. Yes, that's my presentation. I hope that there will be some comments or questions.
Yes, sir. I see a few of the questions on the chat box. And one is by our immediate past president, Abdul Saya. He is asking, are you the only organization for blood donors in Denmark?
Yes, we are the only blood donor organization in Denmark. We only have a voluntary unpaid donation that is so by law, and we have no competitors, so to speak. But we have a very good cooperation with the blood banks. It could have been a part of the blood bank organization. It is in many countries, I know. But here in Denmark, we have this private organization, and we are covering the whole country. And there are no other blood donor organizations. There are other donor organizations. We also work within stem cells, but not in other kinds of donations.
Okay, so I think Abdo have a few more questions. So I would like to invite Abdo for his questions.
Thank you. Thank you, doctor, for your presentation, and hello from Beirut. I just wanted to, this is not the real background behind me, by the way, I just changed it as an effect. I just wanted to ask you about the funding. You mentioned something about you as an organization getting paid or getting funded by an amount of 7 or 8 euros per plasma donation, if I'm not mistaken. I just wanted to know, so if you're not the ones who actually draw this blood or plasma, you just encourage people to go and donate. So you get paid by the blood banks eventually, or by the government, or are the blood banks anyway run by the government, or are there separate entities?
Yes, they are separate entities. It's local governments. We have five local governments in Denmark, and each of them have a blood bank organization. And in the same way, we have five regional organizations, and these regional organizations are required by law to agree upon the terms of our help, including how we are funded. So it's regional government funding, so to speak, and it's negotiated locally. So we are not from the national level in any way in a part of that, just the same way as the government itself is not a part of that.
Thank you.
Thank you. Any other individual, any other participants do have any sort of questions, please feel free to ask. Okay, so I don't see any sort of questions in regards of the presentation by Dr. Fleming. So I'd like to thank Dr. Fleming for his time and encouraging youths like us in regards of blood and blood donation. It was really nice having you in our International Youth Forum. Thank you, Dr. Fleming.
A pleasure being here.
Thank you, thank you.
I just want to say that if any of you want to look at our material and use it in any way and have issues with that, you're of course always welcome to contact me, and I'll help with the translation or anything else.
Sure, sure. I'll convey the same thing to all our members as well. So now moving towards the further part of the program, further part of the day. So now, as we know, we are at the very end of the day as well, with all our presentations. And now we'll be it's our last day, and we'll be inviting you for not for the virtual forum, but firsthand forum in Nepal next year. So I will be giving presentation in regards of presentation in regards of inviting you for a forum next year. But before that, I would like to request Francesca to assist me with the videos from the previous forums, the forum back in Lebanon and the forum back in Azerbaijan. So I request Francesca to help me out for that.
Yes, yes, Arian.
Thank you, Francesca.
The program is Yalla, exchange, explore, enjoy. The success of the forum depends on you guys. So the more we share, the more we exchange, the more we explore, the forum will be better.
Witnesses of good deeds.
The experience is really everyone's story was actually the most memorable thing about this forum.
Thank you to all of you, and you made my forum.
Everything was great.
I really enjoyed listening to the speakers there. I learned so much.
Everything was really well played and organized.
I hope that we'll be able to do a comparable job when organizing future forums.
Motivation and inspiration is the word I'm taking with me home.
like them or Lebanese people or their
relatives. You seem like a really great family and you make us all feel like we are your family too.
It was a pleasure having you guys. I hope you enjoyed your stay.
I feel thank you for organizing this event, which has been a success. It has been great to be working on this and making your choices for the future.
Yes, it was 16th Youth Forum, International Youth Forum in Lebanon, and now we are moving for a 19th International Youth Forum in Azerbaijan Baku last year.
My name is Tatiana and I'm from Lebanon. I'm very happy to be participating in the IYF 2019 in Baku. We're super happy to be here because we're exploring, exchanging new cultures and meeting a lot of new people, plus we're learning a lot of new things. So moreover, on the 21st of September, it's the World Peace Day. So I invite all of you to join us into this Peace Day and donate blood because it's a way of doing peace because it's against race, ethnicity, religion, etc.
Francesca, can you hear me?
She guided me there for me too.
Hi, I'm Diana from Romania. I'm super excited to be in Baku in Azerbaijan, learning new things from our brothers and sisters all over the world. I'm happy to see that the government is also supporting blood donation, and I think this is what should happen in every country. We still have some progress to do on that in Romania. And don't forget that on the 21st of September is World Peace Day, and the best way that we can celebrate that is by showing empathy and love to all our brothers and sisters around the world.
I'm Davide from Italy.
I am attending this forum in Azerbaijan. I think that this event is really interesting for me. I met a lot of people from different countries. We shared our problem about blood donation in our countries, and I think that it is a very useful thing to improve our organizations in our countries.
So these two were the videos, one from the 16th International Youth Forum in Lebanon, and the other one was from 19th International Youth Forum in Baku, Azerbaijan. So this year we were to have this similar forum, 20th International Youth Forum in Nepal, but unfortunately, because of the circumstances created globally, the global pandemic COVID-19 is all around us, and that is the reason why we had to postpone the International Youth Forum 2022 to 2021 in Nepal. And we had to decide to have one as a virtual forum to connect you all in this platform from Microsoft and have you all. So I'll be presenting the presentation of international to invite you all for International Youth Forum for 2021 in Nepal. So shall I start? Well, I will be doing it myself, I guess. Yes, it will work for me. So can you see my screen?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Yes.
So it's International Youth Forum 2021 is the official logo, which was same for the 2020. So let's talk about Nepal. So Nepal is a small country in South Asia, located mainly in the Himalayas. If you have heard about the name, the Mount Everest, yes, exactly. Mount Everest is the land where Nepal lies. And Lord Buddha, Gautam Buddha was born in Nepal in a place called Lumbini. The area of Nepal is 147,516 square kilometer. And the capital of Nepal is Kathmandu, if you haven't heard about it. And talking about the religion, although majority of people out here are Hindu, but it's a secular country with Hindu, Christian, Muslim, and Buddhist living in this country. Kathmandu is the city with a maximum number of 7 UNESCO World Heritage Sites in the world. And we have got only an international airport in Nepal, that is Tribhuvan International Airport in Kathmandu. But we were to have this Gautam Buddha International Airport being completed by 2020, but because of the pandemic time, the time has been increased. So talking about our organization, Club 25 Nepal, we already had a presentation regarding Club 25 Nepal, but let me tell you a brief introduction about Club 25 Nepal. Club 25 Nepal was established in 2006, and it is a sister organization to Blood Donor Association of Nepal, which is the largest blood donor association in Nepal. And it is one of the stakeholders along with the government of Nepal and Nepal Red Cross Society. And Club 25 Nepal is a partner organization of Club 25 International as well. And Club 25 mainly works with the motto of reaching young blood donors. So we normally encourage people to donate blood starting their 18th birthday. So when are we going to have International Youth Forum in Nepal? We know it's in 2021, but the exact date for the International Youth Forum is 18th of August to 22nd of August. That is the main event. And we have a bit of twist, as we have already shared. I had already shared in Baku as well. So we are going to have something optional as well. So from 22nd to 26th of August in 2021, we'll be having a trekking event. As you all know, Nepal is a mountainous country with Himalayas, with the 8th highest mountain in the world out of 10 highest mountain in the world. So the venue is this hotel where we had already fixed with the arrangements. So why IYF? As you already saw the video, what we have in IYF, but I would like to share a few things. We have the event day. It's a market day. On the very first day, we have a market where people from different countries share their culture, share their food, share their organization. As we know, all of us are from the blood donor organization and the same fraternity. So we share our culture and tradition and blood theme. We work in a group. Yes, definitely. We work in a group in this entire IYF period. Blood bank visit. Yes, whenever we have IYF, we get a chance to visit the respective blood banks, like we did in Baku, then in Portugal, then in Lithuania, then in Lebanon, then in Morocco, then in Italy. We got a chance to see the blood banks of the respective country. Activity. Yes, we do have outdoor activities in IYF. It's a picture from a yoga practice by a yoga teacher from India in Azerbaijan. Visits. We do have plenty of time to visit with our friends from different countries. Friends, food and fun. Yes, definitely. IYF is a major attraction because of the friends, food and fun. We have a lot of fun with friends. We enjoy, we spend time together, and those become our memories. So it's all about memory, sharing our memories. So what's extra in Nepal? Additional trekking activities. We have additional trekking activities in Nepal. So which will be from 22nd to 26th of August in 2021. So Pokhara, the trekking, first destination would be Pokhara, where we have a lot of lakes. There are 7 lakes in the same city, and we have plenty of like cycling activities, paragliding, rock climbing, and bungee activities in this city. Trekking. So we have a trekking for three days. We do trekking for 3 days, where we'll be staying in local houses with local people, with the authentic local foods and local culture. So why IYF 2021 in Nepal? So highest figure in voluntary blood donation in South Asia. We are having the highest voluntary blood donation in entire South Asia region. We have the largest countries like India, Pakistan, Bangladesh with a huge population, but we have the largest voluntary blood donation. That is 98% voluntary blood donation, and 2% is replacement blood donation. That is how replacement blood donation is. We work along with other organization to call the donors for whenever it is required. Like if some patient party requires a blood, we can call, we have a database, and we get to call those people and try to replace the donors. And we know that we last had an international youth conference in Asia was back in 2016 in Lebanon. So it's the second time in last 5 years we are having International Youth Forum in Asia. That is in 2021 in Nepal. So yes, we have been active IFBDO members since 2006. So that is also another reason for IYF here in Nepal. And the other reason is it's really easy to get visa for Nepal. So we don't need any kind of visa prior to your travel. So it's on arrival visa for most of the countries except few. So a few countries have to apply for the visa, but we know the visiting countries from the earlier youth forums, I presume that most of the countries, they don't need any kind of visa earlier. So it's on arrival. So you can plan your travel anytime you like. So to promote voluntary blood movement in this region, we know like there are kind of problems in this region, in this part of the world. So the people around the world should know what are the problems in this region as well. like Siri shared it yesterday regarding Bangladesh with Rohingya people. So yes, there are certain problems in these regions. So it should be known by all other donors and volunteers across the world. So it's definitely a better platform to showcase what the people from this region are doing and how they are conducting blood movement. And yes, we have 5 days of event and 5 days of trekking optional event as well. And like we are going to provide, like I shared last year, we are going to provide few 100% scholarship to participants who are in need, who are deserving candidates. We could see there were many people who were willing to attend in earlier forums, but because of some issues, financial issues or some sort of issues, we had less participants from South America and Africa. So to promote volunteers from such regions, we are going to provide few scholarship, 100% scholarship for participants and to increase the number of participants. Yes, definitely. Nepal is in between a huge chunk of countries, and we are hopeful to get people from West and East as well. So it's a better way to better place to have more people because of the flexibility of visa condition and other reasons. Yes, blood volunteerism is the reason why we wish to show it to the people. We can donate blood in a different manner than or different system than in the European region. So we want to showcase this. Places, definitely. Whenever you are planning to join in any of the International Youth Forum, you definitely want to have some sort of visits. So we have plenty of places to visit in and outside the Kathmandu. So we have 7 UNESCO World Heritage Site in entire Kathmandu, and we would be visiting most of them in the period of our IYF activities. Yes, we are a mountainous country. We have trekking activities, paragliding activities, and we have bungee facilities as well. Food. We are different than the world. We enjoy different food. We have a different kind of fooding system. So we want to show people what we eat and how we eat. So we want to have you all here in Nepal to enjoy our food as well. People. Although Nepal is a small country, we have a total of 47 ethnicity in this small country. So we want to showcase you those people who are living in harmony and peace in a small region. See you next year in Nepal. Thank you.
Thank you, Arian.
Yes, so any questions in regards of the presentation, I am more than happy to answer those questions. Okay, so I don't see any kind of questions from the participants. So I would like to request European Continental Delegates Francesca to address the forum. Francesca, thanks of note to the forum participants.
Francesca, you need to unmute yourself.
Sorry. Thank you, Tat. So thank you, everyone. Yes, I was saying that we are almost done with this forum that is really particular. We try to make our best, actually, because we didn't want to miss the chance to meet all of you, even in these difficult times for each other, for everyone, actually. So this was an experiment, a test to see if we could connect each other as we always do and we have always done during past forum. And actually, seeing again the video of the past and the previous forum, what I saw is that we have a lot of memory and a lot of things shared together. So actually, I think that even if next year the things will be different because, of course, pandemic is going to change every one of us, I think we will keep our energy, our strength, and our commitment to stay together, to connect each other, to really be a family that has just one aim, that is helping others through blood donation. And actually, as I said, in 2016, all of you made my forum this year, like every year. So thank you everyone, and I leave the stage to Tatiana. Thank you.
Okay, so I think everyone knows me by now, but I'm gonna reintroduce myself. I'm Tatiana. I'm the Young Asian Continental Delegate. So first, what I want to tell you guys is to add a bit on what Ariane said about Nepal. So this year it was a virtual forum. I know this is not what we wished for, because we really like to see each other since we are a family. I'm so happy to see new faces, and especially new countries, and especially from Asia, because since this is my fifth forum, so since 2016, we only had maximum two countries from Asia participating in the forum. So this year we have six. I know it's virtually, I know, because we have a lot of problems from visas to the economy and some barriers to participate. But I really hope that next year in Nepal, we will see way more countries from Asia, because we can learn a lot from each other. Especially, it's not like the European countries where we have some differences in the blood donation. And I really hope that everyone from the European country that we usually have in the forum will come as well to Nepal. I know it's not so cheap to get a flight ticket, but I can assure you that Ariane and his team are working really hard to host all of you, and that you will learn a lot from all of us here in the other part of the world. So hope to see you, all of you there. It was so nice to see so many familiar faces as well this year. So what we're gonna do is, like every year, we end our forums by sharing some positive feedback or evaluation or some kind words to each other for the next year. So I'm gonna start inviting every one of you to just, if you can, turn on your camera, if you'd like. If you don't, it's fine. Turn on your mic, and if it doesn't work, if you can type it, and give us some, whatever you wanna say to each other or about the forum, how did you find it? And I know it wasn't the ideal forum that we would have, but it's fine, because at least we saw each other in a way, and we talked to each other. So anyone wants to start, or should I start inviting people? All right, I'm going to start by the participants in an alphabetic order, since it's easier for me. So Anna? I cannot hear you.
Anna, you available?
All right. Ariane, no, not Ariane. Beatrice? No, Selena, I can see you.
Yeah, I think it was just amazing to see how many people showed up for this, even though it was online. And of course, I know we all wanted to be in Nepal right now, but yeah, I think it went really well. It was just lovely to see everyone again.
All right, thank you. Carol? Is it right how I'm pronouncing the name? I'm not sure. Kao, can you hear me? No. All right, Claudia.
Claudia? Tatiana, are you speaking with me?
Yes, can you share with me a small feedback or anything you want to say to the others?
Really, I'm very happy that I saw you, all of you these days. I'm happy that you, Tatiana, and all of you guys from Beirut are fine. I was really scared.
Thank you.
And I hope that next year we will saw each other, all of us, in Nepal.
Hope to see you as well. Dahalu Rusha?
Hello. Actually, this is my first forum, so I enjoyed thoroughly and hope to see you all next year in Nepal. Thank you.
Amazing. Elena?
Okay, I remember to turn my mic on. So what can I say? It doesn't matter where we are. It doesn't matter how we communicate to each other. What matters that we are a family. And in this family, it's important to support each other and to congratulate each and every one of you for the amazing efforts you have done during the past year in this pretty hard time. And I'm pretty sure that next year will be awesome. We'll make it awesome.
Thank you. Evangelia?
Hello.
Hey.
I'm so happy, Tatiana. I would like to thank you all for this opportunity, for my first forum, for me. It's very interesting to learn many informations, and I hope you see in Nepal, Ariane.
Shame you.
Thank you very much.
Most welcome.
Amazing, thank you. Fleming? I don't know if I'm pronouncing your names right, guys. So if not, I'm sorry.
Yeah, that's fine. Well, I'm a lot older than all of you, and I will like to say to you that I'm really confident that this blood donor movement has a bright future ahead of us when I see all of you. Thank you for your effort. Really, thank you.
Thank you for your contribution.
Welcome.
Giulia? No. Yes, no, no. Okay, Liliana?
Sorry, my mic don't work.
Oh, okay.
Are you hearing me?
Yes, I can hear you.
Hello, everyone. It was a pleasure to participate one more forum with you all of all of you, even though it's virtual. It was very good, great to share information with all. I hope to see you soon. Bye.
Thank you, Luisa.
Hi, can you hear me?
Yes, we can hear you.
Okay. this was my first forum also for me. So I just say it was a pleasure to meet all of you and spend this time with you. It was an interesting forum. I hope you can we can see Nepal in next year. And thank you for all.
Thank you. Massimiliano.
Do you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you.
Okay, it was a pleasure to take part to this forum. I'm happy to see all you, all of you. Can you hear me?
Yes.
Okay. Thanks to Dr. Karin and Dr. Fleming. And the other relators too, as Siri yesterday, or Francesca for the games, Ariane as a moderator, Tatiana too. And it was a pleasure also to meet new country that we had in the past forum, we had the possibility to meet them, like India, Indonesia, or El Salvador. And it's a good way to decrease the distance between us. So I hope to see you next year in Nepal.
Thank you. Medine? No. All right, Mila?
Mila won't be able to. Okay.
She didn't have a mic.
Okay.
She wrote in the chat. Yeah.
Okay. Lien?
Yes, it's my first forum, and I think, guys, you did a very good, great job hosting this virtual forum. The sessions were very interesting, and I'm so excited for next year, and I hope to meet you all there. Thank you.
Thank you. Noemi?
This was my first forum. It was beautiful, even if 1,000 thanks. Bye.
All right, thank you. Rodrigo?
Hear me?
Yes.
Okay, so this was a very interesting alternative that you guys came up with due to the situation, of course. But I think you guys did a great job hosting this. And I think we can learn that we can use this platform for so the people that cannot join us physically in the forum. So that's a challenge for Arian next year in Nepal to kind of provide like a streaming service for the forum for the people that are unable to participate physically. So hope to see you guys next year.
Thank you. Sarah?
Okay, hi everyone. It was a pleasure. This was my first forum and I really liked it. I would have liked to meet you all in person so I could like get to know you better, but it was honestly a great experience and you all have good spirit. It's shown through your presentation and through your participation and can't wait to see more, to see you more. So thank you all.
Thank you. So, Gat?
Hello, everyone.
Hello.
Hello. It's my first time to be in this forum, and I'm really happy. And I would like to congratulate all of you, directly and indirectly, contributing to make this forum a successful one. And I'm really happy that you guys came with this virtual event in this pandemic also. And hope to see you all in next year in Nepal. And Mr. Upreti, I really like your Nepali topi because I don't have that sample piece. have a good day, everyone.
Thank you, you too. Siri?
Yes, I think this was really good. It was my fourth forum, and of course, I was disappointed and sad that I weren't able to meet all of you guys in Nepal, but I'm really happy that we did something. I feel like doing this is so much better than just not doing anything and waiting until next year to do anything at all. So I'm really happy that you guys did this. So I want to like thank everyone who worked on doing this digital forum. I think it's really creative and a great solution, and I'm so excited to see everyone next year.
Thank you, Siri. Taran?
Yes, this was really nice to see all of you guys again and have some input because it was less than it used to be, but it's still really, really good. It's a great job of everyone. And I love how you included the social as well with the games and all of it. So very good job.
Thank you. Yasmin?
Hey, so I just wanted to say that although that this has been
a virtual conference, I guess that it was a nice opportunity to boost the participation of people who are attending for the first time. And once you attend for the first time, you're just looking forward to other times. So that would probably get the rates of participation up. I also want to say that this was successful because of all the collective efforts that each and every participant have put here, whether they were just talking, presenting, or doing things that were not, that were in the background. So thank you and every one of you.
Thank you. I know that some people were as well in the call, but I can't see their names. So Tommaso, Matteo, Monica, if anyone is still here and wants to share something, or if I didn't tell a name and you are in the call, please feel free to add anything or talk. Matteo, are you here?
Hi, Tatiana, can you hear me?
Yes.
Hi, guys.
We missed
thank you.
You
for thank you for this visual forum. It was amazing. I hope to see you in Nepal next year.
We hope to. Tommaso, are you here? No, I think he left. Monica left. All right. Is there anyone who didn't
yes,
talk?
Yes, I just joined it. Monica?
Oh, Monica is here? Yes, Monica.
I think no.
Okay, so no.
No.
Hi, this is Chao.
Chao.
Yeah, this is program from Assam. I'm really pleased to be part of this forum. As a blood donor, we are just club. We are donating blood from 2014, but the networking with other blood donor organization is lacking. And now I think this is a very good initiative. Once we have good networking, it gives the motivation to our volunteers also. And last year in Baku, I missed the forum because I was having another UN conference in Bangkok. So during the same time, I hope due to pandemic, I missed this event in Nepal 2020, and but 21, I'm definitely going to Nepal with some of our volunteers, and hopefully I'm going to see you next forum also. Thank you.
Thank you. Okay, is there anyone else? Okay, before inviting my IYC colleagues to talk and give us one message, like Ariane, Narmin, Simon, Francesca, I just want to say one last thing is that normally when we end our forums, we take a group picture. I know this is not possible this year, but we all have our screens. And I think that each person of us can see different people because we don't fit in all of us in the screen. So what I wanted to ask you is those who did not put their camera, if they can, it's perfect. If not, it's okay. If every person can print screen their screens and send it to us on our social media or by email, you have our emails, you have us on Instagram and Facebook. For those who don't have us, please do follow us on Facebook, IYC, International Youth Committee, the page. And on Instagram, we have our account, iyc.fiods. So if you can print screen your screens and everyone smile.
Cheese.
I'm gonna enter full screen so I can see more people. Right. Don't forget to send them. So, Francesca?
Yes? Okay.
Do you want to add something? And then I'll give Simon, Ariane, and Narmin
Sure. Yes, I just shortly. I would like to thank you all the participants again, because actually was really impressive meeting all of you and see how passionate you are, because it's difficult to connect in different times, different hours, but we are online a great number, so it's really nice, and it's really warming for our souls, actually, because every year we get energy from our forums to go on with our volunteering activities next year, and now I think is the same. And after this, I want to thank you, my friends in the IYC board, because actually it's really a pleasure every time to collaborate and to create something nice. So thank you everyone, Ariane, Tatiana, Simon, Armin, and Dunia. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Francesca. Simon?
Now I'd like to invite Simon.
Okay, thank you. Hello, everyone, again. And of course, I really would like to thank you all who took part to this forum in these 3 days, despite the COVID-19 pandemic situation. This year we are all distant, but we were united with this platform, and I think it was a quite strange forum, but I really appreciated as well, because you were all brilliant, you were all perfect, you were all warming. And you were all my brother, my blood brothers and sisters. So we always say that IYC is a big family. That's true, because we are like brothers and sister. And I really appreciated these 3 days that were really brilliant. I would also thank all the speakers who have reached the forum in these 3 days with their lesson. They were really brilliant, they were perfect, and their lesson were very good. And see you all in Nepal 2021. Hope everything's good. Thank you.
Thank you, Simon. So before...
Ariane, just one last thing before, because actually you can't thank yourself. So I want to thank you on behalf of everyone for moderating this event. I know it's difficult to moderate, especially online with the connection that is happening. So thank you so much for doing this. Thank you for all the participants. Really, like Simon said, we are a family. And in times like these, we know and we can see that we are really a family. I know that during the pandemic, we always asked about each other through social media. We stay connected together. And this is our power, to connect the world together. And I really hope that everyone will stay in the Facebook group, so we can stay in contact together, stay in touch until we meet again. So Ariane, the floor is yours, and Narmin as well. Thank you.
So thank you, Tatiana, and thank you, team of IYC. And I would like to, at the very end of the entire forum, I would like to thank each and every participants for their kind hearing and being with us for entire 3 days. And I would like to thank all the speakers who helped us to make this forum a successful one. And yes, before giving the floor for closing notes by Narmin, the president of IYC, I would like to tell you all that we would be sending you a form with a review form. And I request each and every one you to fill the form, and after you submit the form, we will be sending you with your certificates of participation. So we would be sending you form later than tomorrow, and we request you to send back those forms with your feedbacks and what changes you need, and what were the comments, what we could improve in our coming future. And we hope to get similar kind of virtual forums in coming days as well. And lately I would like to to request you all to forgive me if I have made any kind of mistakes in my entire moderation time. And I would like to thank you all for your participation and leaving this floor and and inviting you for next year in Nepal. I would like to thank you all and say goodbye as a moderator for today. Thank you all, and would like to invite Namin, the president of IYC, for closing note. Namin, over to you. Thank you all.
Well, hi, everybody. I was listening to you guys, and I was just holding myself, maybe not to cry a little bit, because I was like super, I don't know how to tell it. Well, I remember that when we started, when we canceled the forum in Nepal due to the pandemic, we were very like upset. I mean, not because we couldn't travel or something. We're just very upset because we didn't have a chance to meet the same people, I mean, or the new young blood donors from different countries. And we had a lot of, even with Arian, we discussed many times how to improve the forum. We checked the feedback forums from the previous year. But when we decided to make it on virtual, to do on a plot on online, we're like, okay, how we are going to attract people, because now they are busy, and our goal is not to have people from only one or two continents. We wanted to have people, for example, from North America, North and South America as well, that have never participated in any of the forums. Even like, for example, the guys who joined from El Salvador, it was 6 a.m. there. When we decided the time, first it was like 10 a.m. but GMT, which is like, let's say 12 p.m. with Italian time. So we're like, wait, we cannot do it because it's 4 a.m. In this part of the world. So I was like, okay, guys, let's push it, let's change the date, not the date, let's change the time. So, I mean, We're super excited, and now I don't know. I'm just happy to have you guys here. I hope that we manage to give you, I don't know, we manage to give you something, and so you don't think that okay, we spend you could think that yeah, these 3 days were valuable. We learned something, even though we couldn't make it in Nepal, but still on virtual, it was still fine. And also, once again, I would like to say thanks to all our speakers, Dr. Karin and Dr. Fleming, for today's sessions, and also Siri and Khalil for yesterday. And there is something that I really liked from the Dr. Fleming's speech that I would like to mention once again. He mentioned a couple of times that never forget or never afraid of repeating yourself when you explain someone that you are a blood donor and what is the value of being a blood donor and how someone who is new, who has no idea about the blood donation, can save 3 lives once when he or she donates blood donates blood just once. So I think we all need to remember it all the time. And me personally, like probably I also took a note of that sentence and in order not to forget it. So I think, okay. I'm super a little bit excited. Well, we are on behalf of IYC team, I would like to say thanks once again to each one of you for joining us and for sharing this time with us. And as everybody mentioned, well, see you in Nepal next year. And don't forget that we are blood donors, and feel always proud of yourself being a blood donor. So I'm done. So have a nice day, everybody. Have a nice day, everybody. I know that it depends on the cities and the countries. So maybe if it is evening, then good night. And yeah, and bye-bye. So yeah, see you in Nepal, in Kathmandu next year. And follow us on Facebook, Instagram to get more updated information. And whenever you have any idea and you see that, okay, we can do it on virtual. So just feel free to write us whenever you want. We are email or Facebook or Instagram. We are always happy to hear you guys. So, love and kisses.
Bye, guys.
Thank you again.
Bye.
One love.
Bye.
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 See you guys.
Bye.